It took 4 years for the mail to arrive. Abdelkarim Nabil, known by his blogger name Karim Amr, goes through a pile of letters from supporters around the world. Last week, he was released from an Egyptian prison after serving a 4-year sentence. His case was picked up by bloggers around the world. His crimes? Defaming Islam and insulting President Hosni Mubarak on his blog. He comes from a pious Muslim family, but rebelled against them and his strict religious upbringing. Karim studied law at a branch of the conservative Islamic Al-Azhar University, and it was the university that reported his blog to the authorities. His determination to defy convention may have been what landed him in prison. He says, there are things we inherit without even thinking about them. I tried to change my way of thinking. I tried to read what was forbidden in our house, things written by people who in my home and in religious institutions are considered infidels. He's a rarity in increasingly conservative Egypt, an unrepentant secularist. Prison life didn't steal his sense of humor, however. He recalls that the worst torture behind bars was having to watch state-run TV. The internet is one of the last spaces where Egyptians can vent their anger, but for Karim and others, it is far from risk-free. Fellow blogger Wael Abbas says he's been under cyber attack for years from the security services.
There are troubles that start online, like trying to hack into your website, trying to block it, trying to destroy it, disabling your accounts by sending fake reports that you are posting inappropriate material, like they did with my YouTube and with my email and with my Facebook.
There are no restrictions on the internet in Egypt. You can go to whatever site you like. But the case of Karim Amr and others have earned Egypt a place on the group Reporters Without Borders list of enemies of the internet. Before his release, Karim says police officers beat him one last time and sent him off with a stern warning not to blog again. They threatened to arrest me and torture me, he says, but I'm not going to listen to them. The Egyptian government routinely denies abusing detainees, but it will almost certainly be listening to Karim. Ben Wiedemann, CNN, Cairo.